Hello, grade 8 students. How's you all? I hope you all are fit and fine at your home. So, welcome back to the computer class. Dear students, in the last class, we discussed a chapter that is HTML. Students, HTML is a designing language and it is very interesting language. Okay, so in last class we discussed some tags and element. Different type of elements are there and different type of lists are there and font tag also. So in today's class we discuss what is table and what is marquee tag. So let's start. Yes, students, here first tag is marquee tag. So what is marquee tag? Marquee tag display a moving text message on the background of a web page. You can add a marquee to your web page by using marquee tag. Okay. In a marquee tag, there are some attributes are also there like width, height, behavior, background color, or different type of directions are there in a marquee tag. Now I will tell you what is marquee in a practical way. Yes, students, see the example of marquee tag. Here first tag is HTML, then head, and inside the head HTML marquee tag is there, and after that we close the head. This is the first part, and in the second part body, we start the body tag, and here different type of marquee attributes are there. First is marquee direction. There are four directions are there. First is up, down, left, and right. For differentiate, I give the background color. In up, I give the BG color, that is purple. And in second, down, BG color is blue. And in direction left, BG color is red. And in direction right, BG color is green. Okay, student. Next attribute is scroll amount. Here, first is 1, and in scroll amount I give the value 20. What is the meaning of 1 here? Means if we want to move the marquee in a very slow speed, then we give 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. But if we want to give the scrolling marquee in a very high speed, then we give 20, 30, 40. Likewise, we increase the number also. Okay, so next attribute is loop. Loop means repetition. Yes, if we want to repeat the loop of marquee, so we give the number. For example, I give here 2. It means the marquee loop will continue till 2 times. If I give 3, then it will continue 3 times. If I give 4, then it will continue 4 times. Okay, students, this is notepad. I type the code here. After that, now I will show you what is the output of this. See here, this is the marquee up, and the blue form is down, and same that is in orange color, that is right to left, and that is in a green color, that is left to right. That we give in the yellow color, that is slow speed. Okay, student, scroll amount is 1 here, and in blue, that after that pink color is here. Yes, high speed is there, so scroll amount 20 is there. Okay, and last one is, that is in a orange color, that is loop. How much time we repeat our marquee? Okay, marquee is a direction. Okay, same like scroll amount also there, and even loop is also there. Okay, students, that is clear. Yes, students, next topic is table. So what is table? Table is arranged data in a row and a column format and provide an attractive way to organize information. Tables are created to present information in a proper manner and make comparative analysis of data. To create a table in HTML, we need a table tag, and there are some more element or tag are also there, like tr for table row, th for table heading, and td for table data. Okay, tr for table row, th for table heading, and td for table data. And also there are some attribute are there in a table tag. See that these are the main attributes of table that supports the table tag. First is ABBR, abbreviation tag. Okay, abbreviated text. Second is align. There are four type of alignment are there in a table: right side alignment, left side alignment, center, justified. Okay, and then background is also attribute of table. That is, here we have to add the color name or color code. Then next attribute is border. If we want to add the border thickness, so we also add the border, like 1, 2, 3, the value in a number form. And next attribute is cell padding, and then cell spacing. What is cell padding and cell spacing? Cell spacing is space between the cell. Okay, and cell padding means space inside the cell. Okay, if we want to increase the space inside the cell, that is cell padding. And if we want to increase the space in the two cells, then we use cell spacing. Yes student, that is HTML. We start the HTML tag, then in the head section there is a title is there. What is title here? HTML table header. First part is completed here. Now we start the second part, that is body. In the body we add the table tag. In table there are some attributes are there, like border, border color, background color, and so many more. In border, if we want to give the table border, then we give the value 1. If you want to increase the thickness of border, we also increase the value of border, like 2, 3, 4. The second attribute is border color. Here border color is green. Okay, the value of border color is green. If you want to change the value of color, so you have to change the color also, like blue, red, yellow. Third is BG color. BG color means background color of table. Here is yellow. If you want to change the background color, you also change the value of that color. So here, how many tr is there? 3 tr is there. First tr, then close. Second tr, then close. Then third tr tag, then close. Why? Because there are 3 rows are there. Tr means table row. In a first row, heading is there, and other 2 rows, table data is there. Okay, th means table heading. So 2 heading are there in a first row. What is that? Name and roll number. Okay, and in second row there is a data, Karan and 12. Karan is a name and roll number is 12. And in same in the third row, Dia is here. Dia is a name and data is 14, means roll number is 14 here. Okay, after that we close the row, then we close the table tag, then we close the body tag. In the end we close the HTML tag. Okay students, now I will show you the output. Here background color is green and BG color is yellow. Okay, see here, 3 rows are there in a first row, headings are there, name and roll number. Second row, some data is there, name Karan and roll number 12. And in the third row, Dia is here and the 14 roll number. Okay, here the table border is there. Okay, and border color is green. Okay, and here background color is yellow. I hope this is clear to all. I will tell you the another example of table also. See the another example of table tag. Here all the things are same, but some new concepts are there. There are some attributes, that is self-padding, self-spacing, height, width and alignment. Yes, three type of alignment is there, left, right and center. Width, we also increase the width also and also increase the height also if we want in the some changes in the table. Okay, one new concept is there, self-padding, and second is self-spacing. What is self-spacing? There is a space between the cell. And what is self-padding? If we want to add the space in between the cell, in the cell wall and cell value. Okay, that is self-padding. Okay, some three rows are there, that is same. In first row, two headings are there, name and roll number. And in second row, two type of data is there, name is Kamal and roll number is 12. And the third row also, name is Dia and roll number is 13. Other things are same here. Now I will show you the output first. Okay, see here, name and roll number, three rows are there. See the space. First, alignment. Alignment means that all the table in the not in left side, that is in the right, that is in the center. Okay, so see that in the space between the cell, that is cell spacing, and space in the cell is, that is a student cell padding. Okay, or even border is also there. Okay students, that other things are same. Yes students, I hope these texts are clear to all. Please do the practical of these texts also. Okay, HTML practical. Okay students, so in the next class we will discuss the book task of this chapter. Okay students, please do the study. Enjoy your day. Thank you.